Joshua's with us in Ashland, Kentucky. Welcome to the Dave Ramsey Show, Joshua.
Thank you, Mr. Ramsey. It's good to be talking to you.
You too, sir. How can I help?
Just a quick question. I work for a gym, and I've already helped set up a couple of programs there, but it's not, they kind of warped it from what I would like it to be, and so I'm kind of trying to figure out how to either help it, try to grow that program to be able to help people, or strike it on my own. And I don't know where to begin as far as setting goals and even just getting started. So I'm trying to kind of like a health coach type thing with nutrition coaching and weight and exercise coaching.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just trying to figure out where to get started and how to get there.
Great. Very cool. I think you take the skills that you already have and you apply them to goal setting in business. And what that sounds like is, my friend Henry Cloud calls your goal your desired future. And how old are you?
I'm 32.
So when you're 42, what's your desired future with your career?
I'd like to be able to be doing online coaching, have a flexible schedule, be able to work when the kids are at school and when the kids and the wife are home in the evening.
Are you working for someone else in this dream, or are you working for yourself in this dream?
I'd like to be working for myself in this dream.
Okay, cool. Then that's your desired future, is to build a business that allows you to do what you just described. Okay? Now, someone walks into your gym and signs up for you to be their coach, and they're out of shape, their eating habits are poor, they've not worked out ever, and they say, my desired future is to look like you. I need an 8-pack, right? A 12-pack instead of a keg, right? And so if that's what they say to you, they say that's their desired future, first thing you tell them is, well, it's going to be a long road. Strap in.
Yes, sir.
It's going to be incremental progress, and we're going to do the basics to lay a foundation. Am I correct? Is this what you're going to tell them? And we're going to get we're going to get you where you can breathe first so that you can exercise, so that you can breathe, so that you can exercise. And we're going to really look at your food intake. Your caloric intake has to go down while your sweat level goes up and your aerobic activity goes up. And then the weight will drop off and you'll start to beat it. But it doesn't happen quick or easy. It's an incremental step at a time. The tortoise wins the race, not the hare. Anybody tells you that they can get a body like that in 90 days is lying. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Same thing applies to your dream. We just set you a 10-year goal. Now, what is the first step to get to the 10-year goal? What's the second step? And then as we get more sophisticated, what's the next step? And what's the next step? And you named like three different things you were doing. One was online coaching, one was in-person coaching, and one was flexibility around the family. I think I heard that right. And so you need to say, okay, which of those am I going to start with when I do start my own business? In the meantime, business level number one might be to learn a bunch of these things while working for someone else. And just get a really good income and a big pile of money, because I'm going to need a little money to start my first brick and mortar, to start my first little gym. I got to have a little money to get that going. Oh, maybe I don't do that. Maybe I start with in-home workouts with wealthy people who have their own gym. And I become a concierge guy. And so that gets me out on my own, and I've got some flexibility. Oh, while I'm doing that at night, I can work on my online thing and start building that out. And you begin to study and think it through. But what you've got to do is lay out what your steps are. And then your steps will change over the next 10 years, but you still have that desired future that you're aiming at. I mean, you might make more progress or less progress in a workout program that would allow you to change direction there. You might have an injury that would keep you from certain types of workout program while you're trying to do this. I got a friend that was just training for Boston, screwed his back up, blew his Boston training out of the water. He's been bummed out. It was about 6 months ago that happened. But so he'll have to do Boston another year. You know, it was his desired future. That's his goal that you're setting. So you set it in front of you. You adjust to the injuries. You adjust to the setbacks. You take the advantages and the things where you're going faster, and you run fast with those. And it's a go and start, go and start, go and start, go and start. Slow down, go start, slow down. But we're always aiming at the same goal. And it's incremental progress, step-by-step strategy to get there. And that's how you lay this out. And it'll work for you. You can get going. Hold on. I'm going to send you a copy of our business playbook called Entree Leadership, How We Grew Our Business.